So here's my question. When you look at successful people, what thoughts do you have? Well, they probably had a lot of help. They were very lucky. You know, what goes through your mind? What I love to do is research who these people are and what they have to offer and how they got where they are. That's so successful. So I recently was able to be with Henry Winkler. Those of you who remember Happy Days and the Fonz, raise your hands. And he was an icon, and everybody knew the Fonz. Flip, whoa, everybody knew him. So he's been writing children's books, and I have them right here. One is a series of books about a little boy named Hank, and the new one that just came out is called Alien Superstar. And they are really amazing books. And he's been writing them with a woman whose name is Lynn Oliver. And they've sold over 2 million copies of this book. Now, how did Henry Winkler get to be the Fonz, move on in his life, is in a successful playwright, a TV program right now called Barry, and has won awards for it? Was he just born with a silver spoon in his mouth? Well, when he spoke, and it's why I wanted to talk about this now, he talked about a difficulty he had growing up that we have named dyslexia. And he had trouble in school, lots of trouble. Trouble with reading, trouble with math. One of the stories he told I thought was wonderful was, well, wonderful from a vantage point of years later, but he said geometry just trashed him. And he said he took it in school, took it in summer school, took it in school, took it in summer school. I think they probably passed him out of just plain anguish of determination. That's what I want to talk about. This is somebody who had a dream as a little kid that he wanted to be an actor. And he said he had no idea where it came from. Now, all of us have dreams when we were kids. And what I'd like you to do is really do a deep dive into the first maybe 8 years of your life and look at what was your dream or the first 10 years. Because there is a seed of greatness in that and a place for you to begin to really look at different things. So what Winkler was saying when he talked was it's his combination of imagination and determination that saved him. He had to work really, really hard to figure out how to bypass, how to kind of jump over, climb under, push through this thing with a learning disability. And we all know he was very successful in Happy Days and moved on and has done movies. And it was interesting. He was talking about a lull in his career. And he was talking to his manager who said, you know, you've had all these problems as a kid growing up with learning disabilities, with difficulties with dyslexia. Why don't you write about it? And he thought, I don't like to read. I don't like to write. What is he talking about? And this is where I'd like to give you this seed of inspiration. It was imagination plus determination that got him to look at things differently. So the manager connected him with Lynn Oliver, who was an author of children's books. And they've collaborated on 30 plus books and now this new Alien book that just came out. And it's been an incredible collaboration. So if you think that you have a difficulty in any place, any learning difficulty, any physical difficulty, whatever it is that's in your mind, it's the transformation of that thought that's going to move you to a new place. And I'm really encouraging all of us, ladies in particular, because we have been held back for so many years saying, well, you can't do this, you can't do that. We're proving everybody wrong with all the cans and can'ts of the world right now. But the important part that I saw as I listened to Henry Winkler was that he took determination, he took imagination, and he took collaboration and created magic and continues to do so well into his 70s. Yep, time goes on and the Fonz is moving into his elder years, it was wonderful to hear him. It was inspirational to say, whatever your issue is, there are ways to go around it and to make it work. One of the things I'd like to say that he and Lynn did, which is interesting in these books, is they partnered, they collaborated with somebody. And I'm just going to show you this for a minute. They collaborated with somebody who has written books for kids with dyslexia so that the printing is easier for them to see. And if we all began to collaborate, it's a great book. I've been reading it and having a lot of fun with Hank, and I'm getting ready for my little alien who has come to Earth and ended up in Hollywood at the Universal lot, because obviously another alien spaceship there wouldn't even be noticed. So what I'd like to give you today is the idea to take your imagination, go back to sometime in the first 5 to max 10 years of your life, and look at what you love to do. What you love to do, there is something back there. I loved to write, and so I've been writing. I loved it. You know, it was just there. Now, am I a great author? I'm okay. I'm good, but I'm not great, but I'm determined to keep writing. So whatever it is that you have there, take it, use it, become it. And when you see successful people like a Henry Winkler or Lynn Oliver, who's done amazing things with children's books, learn from them. Take courage from what they're saying and doing. And we're going to keep doing deep dives into what makes us wonderful, what moves us to our own personal greatness. We are needed now. The world needs us now. It needs us to all stand up and say what is important and make a difference and connect, collaborate. So I'd like to thank you for listening today, and I'd like you to take the leadership quiz that I have created to see where your stuck points are, because I promise you, a lot of it goes back to what you learned in your original organization, the family, that you bring to your present organization at work. That's just a teaser to give you the interest to really take this leadership quiz, and there are 13 behavior patterns you can look at. And some of us got stuck at one or the other or several of them. I call them sticky. For me, it was the drama queen and it was the rescuer. I'd love to know what patterns you have. So take the quiz. Let's give Henry Winkler a high five for all the great things he's doing, and have a beautiful, wonderful, successful day. Thanks so much. Bye.